how do you plead with an algorithm? That was the question posed by Boris Johnson on the 24th of September 2019, when he delivered a speech to the UN General Assembly. Many of you will also remember what happened less than a year later in August of 2020, the A-level grading fiasco. Because of COVID-19, students could not safely take their exams. So when exams were scrapped, while millions of students across the country were rejoicing, Ofqual was designing an algorithm to award these students their grades instead. Ofqual, so, well, you might think that Ofqual, being a public government department that has existed for over a decade, well, you might think that they would have decided to undertake this task in an open, honest, and well-thought-out manner. Well, that simply wasn't the case. When offered expert help by the Royal Statistical Society, Ofqual refused it on the basis that these experts refused to sign a non-disclosure agreement about information that would have been publicly available anyways under the Freedom of Information Act. But you know, what am I complaining about? It couldn't have been that bad, not when this algorithm was openly backed by people like Gavin Williamson. Gavin Williamson, the former Secretary of State, who openly backed this algorithm, said, and I quote, "I have every confidence that the system we have put in place is a robust system, a system that is fair." So really, I couldn't fault you at all for thinking that, you know, everyone got the grades they wanted and they went home and lived happily ever after. But again, this simply wasn't the case. On results day, there was massive outrage because this algorithm disadvantaged students from lower income and underprivileged backgrounds. It predicted their grades based on the achievements of pupils who attended the school in previous years. This algorithm assessed their, not their attainment, but their background. Millions of students were forced to plead with an algorithm. Boris Johnson later blamed the algorithm for this chaos, calling it mutant. But I don't agree with that, and neither should you. Because as much as we love to throw around the words intelligent and sentient when we're talking about computers, the fact of the matter is that computers are actually incredibly stupid. They just don't do anything unless you tell it to. I believe that we shouldn't have allowed technology to be scapegoated like this, because it means that humans aren't being held responsible for the things that they do with that technology. And, you know, when you're someone as important as, say, you know, a Secretary of State or even a Prime Minister, accountability to the people you're supposed to be serving is essential. The same technology that is being referred to in headlines like robots are taking our jobs is also providing the solutions to the levels of dishonesty and lack of transparency that we see at even the highest levels of our governments today. For example, artificial intelligence is being used in Singapore, the Philippines, and Ukraine to analyze financial transactions to identify corrupt behavior. Because AI offers us the ability to interpret, analyze, and sift through large data sets all in the blink of an eye, artificial intelligence can detect these signs of collusion and corruption much quicker than a human would. This means that the investigations that are carried out are expedited. And this has also led to a general decrease in corruption and specifically tax evasion. Now on to my second example. I'm sure all of you at some point have heard of the word blockchain, even if you haven't got the faintest idea of what it means. But don't worry, here I am to explain it to you. Blockchain is essentially a register or a ledger of transactions. And the reason why it's so important to us today is because it is reliable and virtually impossible to cheat, because it's replicated across a wide system of computers. That means if you wanted to edit the blockchain, you'd have to physically go in and change every single copy of it. In 2018, West Virginia piloted their electronic voting system, which meant that people who could not physically go to the polling station could still vote. This also, the fact that this system was also protected by the blockchain meant that this prevented voter fraud. And to, in this day and age, I don't need to tell you how important it is that we protect these democratic freedoms that we have. Voting, as you all know, is incredibly important because it creates change. Well, you know, hopefully change for the better, but democratic change nonetheless. In Brazil and Mexico, they launched fiscal transparency systems online, which disclose information about public spending, budgets, and procurement. Citizens have access to exactly how much their governments are spending on schooling, welfare, and the military, which allows them to hold their elected officials accountable when they're, so that they can make sure that they're fulfilling the promises they made during their campaigns. As you can see, these digital platforms will be used to revolutionize the relationship between between governments and citizens, because citizens will be allowed to provide feedback and become more involved with the decision-making processes of their governments. And now back to the question that I asked you in the beginning. How do you plead with an algorithm? My answer is that we shouldn't have to. Technology should be used as an aid in making difficult decisions, not as a scapegoat when things go wrong. Technology will and is being used to dismantle our old corrupt systems and make sure that transparency and accountability are the tenets of our new ones. And finally, above all else, I believe that technology should be used to empower people, not to replace them. Thank you.